And we move on to libc aura, which has some recommendations. I was going to say that quite a lot for what I would consider to be one of the lower level libraries. We've got libvorbis, we've got libog, we haven't got SDL installed, we've got SDL 2, but it's optional. I believe we do actually, install SDL a little bit later on. Let's see if we can do that one now. Lib, optional. Yeah, I think I could probably do that now, actually. STL. Right, let's grab hold of that. Extract it. And if there's any, okay, possibly some other options. Let's do the sed first, then put in the configure command. So I've got disable ELSA shared. I think we can ignore those. Okay, let's start the build. And install. So it's got a similar testing suite as STL2. I'm not even going to bother doing that, being it's a bit haphazard. It says you need to manually run them all, and as it says, you have to turn your speakers up. Some of them needed a GUI, which doing this recording I can't easily show, so I won't bother with that. So it's STL libc aura now. So, again, there's a sed here, and I think we can copy all of this. No changes needed. And make check to test it. It's okay, and make install. If you wish to install the examples that you can hack on Theora, install them as a root. Normally I'd install that, but I don't think there's any point in this situation. We've got a specific purpose for this machine. It's not a general purpose machine. Okay, libtheora. Now we move on to FDK AAC. So straightforward installation, there's no test suite. Okay, that's built. Let's install it. And that's done. So the next thing I've got is FreeBD, which may be a dependency of FFmpeg. Yes, I've missed that. It is optional, though. I think I built this because I wasn't sure if it might be used for something like subtitles, possibly. Oh, no, it's a requirement of libass. That's what it is. Okay. So let's do that next. So again, we'll just copy all of the instructions here. They're quite straightforward. Injured test. All good. And now we'll install. And that's done. So now we can move on to libass. Again, straightforward. Disable font config if you didn't install font config. Well, we did. So we won't use that. There's no test suite, so we just install. And that's that one done. So now we move on to FFmpeg. I think this is quite a hefty build. So there's the main package plus a patch to download. There's something here about some harmless warnings may be output by the build process regarding the HTML documentation. This is due to an incompatibility with text info 7 and higher. So we'll start by patching the source, run this sed command in, and we'll copy this humongous configure command, and we'll check the explanation at the bottom, enable lib free type, GPL version 3, non-free. So static enable shared, so debug enable libs, we've got that. DRM. So enable DRM uses switch if libdrm is installed, which we have, to build a camera grab input module, which is useful for screen capturing our streaming. Probably not that important, but I suppose we can add it in, because we've got the library. Enable libftk AAC, we've got that. Lame, we've got. Theorem, Vorbis, we've got. Vorbis and VPX, yep, 264, 265, OpenSSL, or you can use GNU TLS, and enable Pulse I'll add in because we've got Pulse Audio as well. Okay, so that's the configuration done. Now we can start the build. I'll time this, see how long this takes out of interest. Okay, so that has finished building. We've got a command with GCC here. That's done. HTML documentation is built. If you have text live, you can build PDF and PostScript. I'm not going to do that. Doxygen, I'm not going to do that. The fate test suite tests include comparisons with installed files and should not be run before the package is installed. Therefore, if you desire to run them, the instructions are given further below. Okay, so let's do the installation. And we'll skip the PostScript and PDF stuff, the Doxygen stuff. To properly test all the installation, you must have rsync installed, which we did install earlier on. And follow the instructions for the FFmpeg automated test environment. First, about 1 GB of sample files used to run fate are downloaded with the command. So we'll run this and wait for that download to finish. Right, so those samples have been downloaded. Now I can run the test with this command here. I'll time this. And we have to change the number of threads to the number of CPUs available. And it says a successful run should return no errors or warnings, just a list of tests and total amount at the end. So those tests are complete, and we've got 3,984. It says there's more than 3,800. Yet there's no warnings or errors over, so that's all okay. It does say about backing up those samples that are downloaded. If you want to rerun the tests or update FFmpeg, so I'm not particularly bothered about that, but they are a gigabyte or so, it says. Yeah, 1.2 gig, so it would save quite a huge download if that was important. So that is FFmpeg.